Hey guys, welcome back to Children's Church. I'm very happy that you've decided to join us again today. I am here, Emma Grace is here, Ethan's here, you are here, and we're going to have a great time. Are you happy? Let's sing about being happy. Come on.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your life will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, then your life will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, shout amen.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, shout amen.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, then your life will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, shout amen.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, 2 or 3.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, 2 or 3.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, then your life will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, 2 or 3.
I love hearing what the puppets are singing for us. They do such a great job. So much fun to listen to them. Why don't we take a few moments and pray together, okay? Think about your prayer requests, whatever it is that you need to ask God to help you with, and let's take a moment to pray. Can you bow your head and close your eyes? Let's pray together. Father, thank you for today. Thank you for another Sunday where we can be in your word and we can worship and sing together. Lord, I pray for all of the requests that these boys and girls may have today, that you would meet those needs and bless them and help them, Lord. Help them to know that you are with them. Whatever situation they may have need of, that you are there, that you love them, and that you care for them. Lord, thank you for giving us this chance to get to worship you together. Be with us throughout our service today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones too.
George?
Help, Dad, I'm in the pantry. Oh, thank goodness, Dad. I thought I would be stuck in the pantry for the rest of my life.
Son, don't you think Mom would have found you before she started cooking dinner?
Oh, I guess you're right, Dad. I didn't think of that.
What were you doing in the pantry anyway?
Well, Dad, I was looking for a snack and Lucy came by and shut the door and turned off the light.
I'll talk to your sister about that later, but I'm sure she was just playing a trick on you, but that was not a very nice thing to do.
No, Dad, it wasn't. And Dad, I was really scared in there. I found out something about myself today.
What is that, son?
I don't like to be in small, dark places that I can't get out of.
Me too. But son, if we are in places like that, we need to remember that we are not alone.
Well, that's right, Dad. God is always with us, no matter where we are.
Yes, He is, son. And it is important for us to remember that. We should trust God so much that we can praise Him even in difficult, scary times. Even when we feel like we're trapped and all alone.
Sometimes it's not easy to praise God, is it, Dad? I really didn't deserve that mean trick that Lucy played on me. And all I could think about was, how will I ever get out of here?
You're right, son. It's not always easy to remember, but we should try. The Bible tells us to give thanks in everything, in all situations. I'll tell you something that you'll have no problem being thankful for.
Okay, Dad. What is it?
I bought a brand new carton of chocolate chip ice cream at the store today, and I think it's time for a snack.
Yippee! Ice cream! I love ice cream, and chocolate chip is my favorite! Okay, Dad, come on, let's go eat!
Hey guys, I love to see what George is up to every week. He was locked in the pantry. That would have scared me too. I don't like to be in small, tight spaces that I can't get out of either. We're going to talk about Paul again today. Our Bible story is in the book of Acts, chapter 16, and Paul and his friend Silas were locked up somewhere, and they didn't deserve to be. They were put in jail for something that was not even a crime. Paul was preaching, and he came across a young girl, a young lady, who had an evil spirit. And Paul went up to her and prayed for her, and the evil spirit left her. Well, people were making money off of her evil spirit because she was able to tell people's fortunes, and they became very angry with Paul. And they put him in front of the judge, and they stripped off Paul's clothes and Silas's clothes, and they beat them with a whip. And then they put them in jail. Let's see what the Bible says in the book of Acts, chapter number 16, about this. And when they had laid many stripes on them, meaning when they had beaten them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely, who, having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in stocks. So not only did they put them in prison, they put them in the prison inside of the prison, and they bound up their hands and their feet so that they couldn't get away. They were going to make sure that Paul and his friend Silas did not escape. But let's see what happens. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. Isn't that interesting that in a very difficult, hard, bad situation where they are in prison for something that wasn't even a crime, they began to praise God. They started singing, "Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound," or some song like that. And the people around them heard them praising God and singing in the middle of the night. And suddenly the Bible says there was a great earthquake so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately all the doors were open and everyone's bands were loose. And the keeper of the prison, awaking out of his sleep and seeing that the prison doors were open, drew out his sword and would have killed himself. But Paul cried with a loud voice, "Do thyself no harm, for we are all here." And the jailer came in, called for a light, and fell down before Paul and said, "What must I do to be saved?" And that very night, he and his whole family were saved and baptized. When we are in difficult situations, when life doesn't seem like it's fair, and I'll tell you, sometimes life just doesn't seem fair, we should still praise God, sing praises and thank Him, because God is in control. And just like Paul and Silas, other people are watching, right? All of those prisoners and the guard, they saw what happened. So when people see us praising God in the difficult times, then maybe they'll begin to praise God as well. Maybe they will want to know who we know, Jesus Christ, and make Him Lord and Savior of their life also. Let's pray together and ask the Lord to help us to remember to trust Him and to praise Him when we're in difficult times, okay? Father, thank you for the story today about Paul and Silas in jail. Thank you for reminding us that no matter what, when we're having a hard time, when things seem unfair, that we should still trust you and praise you, because people are watching us. They're looking to us, and you're watching us, and you hear us whenever we pray, and you hear us whenever we praise. Father, I pray for every person watching this video that you would bless them, bless their homes, bless their families, keep them safe. If there's one person who may be watching this who does not know you as Lord and Savior, I pray that you would knock on that person's heart's door and help him or her to invite you to come in to be Lord and Savior of his or her life. Father, we thank you for how good you are. We thank you for your blessings. We praise you today for who you are and for all that you do for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hey guys, let's do our memory verse together, okay? I want you to read it along with me, and we will say it together. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. Let's read that together one more time. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. Why don't you see if you can read it one time by yourself? Great job. Let's see if we can do it together one time without the words. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. Good job, guys.
Calling Dr. L.E. Font. Paging Dr. L.E. Font.
Have you guys ever had a really bad day? It seems like all my days lately have been really bad. Well, at least I have my new invention. It makes things really, 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 really small. Right, let's try it out. Now put it in there and shut it. Oh, it's working. It's working. Didn't work. Well, I know that the memory verse today said that in everything give thanks. So, you know what? Maybe I can go find a really, really big sweet tea to go with this. A hamburger, some chicken nuggets, and French fries. But see you later.
Into his room.
I'm not sure why.
he wouldn't stop horsing around. Oh, we better go. See you later, boys and girls.
Bye, guys.
I hope you've enjoyed children's church today. I know that I have. It's been a lot of fun. We're going to sing one more song, so you need to stand up, find you plenty of room to move around, and let's sing, okay? Help us out.
Faith and not by sight. I will trust the one who changed my life. God, my God, I will ever praise you. God, my God, you're my strength. God, my God, I will ever praise you.
Thank you, guys. Please come back and join us again. We look forward to seeing you next time. Have a blessed week. Bye-bye.